He's a senior lecturer of UNILAG, a UNESCO consultant in media and communications. Distinguished ladies and gentlemen, may I bring Dr. Suraj to present his paper entitled Connecting Protocol to Public Relations.
Okay. Thank you, ladies and gentlemen. I think I'm standing on established protocol. And luckily enough, I'm dealing with protocol everywhere. Thanks so much, Mr. Fortune, for bringing me around and for recognizing the importance of academics. Mr. Dawatu has given us a very nice speech, which I listened to very well. But unfortunately, official passport, we academics are not included. Diplomatic passport, we are not recognized in that level. And it's unfortunate that this will both of whatever you are doing. But I've always seen that the brains, the academics, and all this factoring. So Mr. Dawatu, I think after we'll see how we'll talk about that. But just like in a football match, you can score early goal, you can score late goal, you can score a middle goal. In my speech here this morning, I'll score an early goal, I'll score late goal, I'll score the middle goal. My first early goal is, we are talking about connecting protocol to public relations. Now, the first goal is that, one, how many media people are here? That is one. That gives you the difference between protocols and public relations. Protocol generally normally need to avoid press. Why? They disrupt protocol. They disrupt protocol.
Press doesn't keep protocol.
They will just break it. And protocol people are orderly and organized. But yeah, that was why. And I believe that. And that's why you have an heart of order and excellence. But press,
they don't have orderliness.
Because it is that kind of controversy that press makes its own mark. So, but when it comes to public relations attract praise. They want them. In fact, they cannot function without them. If this
central
are the more of public relations, you will see a lot of press around. Because that is their environment. That is my first early goal. And I told you that I'll score the goals at different types. Why the distinction between protocol and public relations? Now, to go forward a bit more, people have different notions about protocol. And many of these notions are not true. In some organizations, they see them as errand boys or errand people, who they can just set or help us take this parcel or facilitate these procedures. Protocols are bigger than that. Protocol is a strategic alignment to organizational productivity. If you have a team and you don't have a protocol officers in that team, I can tell you precisely that you have not organized a very good team.
These are big times that I know I'm not going to. Efficiency is about how procedures are organized something like seamlessly, orderly manner, without any confusion or any controversies. Everybody know where they take their positions. There's no rivals.
But that is how you can organize your organization such a way that you can seamlessly meet the requirement, the external requirement outside. That's protocol. Public relations is about effectiveness, making money, profitability, enhancing branding, the brand image, the perception, of people about the organizations, how they see you, what they see. And how you can influence in the military circles. I do a lot of people in the military. They call it info and influence. How can you inform an influence to be strategy also? That was a second goal. Now, quickly, I've told you, but the third goal, let me score the third goal, is that protocol and public relations, they are two sides of the same coin. Two sides of the same coin. Even protocol side here, you have no seen. That's why I like this team.
Protocol approach to public relations in a fast changing world. The world is changing. These should be exclusively two distinct disciplines. Where it appears that even if a diplomatic person here,
if you go to the history, they want to get into a public relations. You got to see public relations of people are not straightforward. They are changing this. And protocols people, diplomatic people, are people are refined. Who want to be taken by their words. But the public relations officer want to manage situations and manage crisis. People don't want to sit with them. One of my encounter with protocol is when I was serving in domestic many years. And then I went to see, I have the culture of taking children and liking them. I didn't know the children I was playing with is the chief protocol officer of the government. So before the man comes back, he'll have eaten in my house. Ah, the man, they said, Daddy, you have eaten in a copper's house. Ah, which is this? Every day. So one day he said for me, so I want to see this copper. And he said, okay, today we'll go to government's house together. And say, I saw the protocol for the first time. And believe me, I love it. The way they cast, they know who I am. They didn't, in fact, people were coming from different areas. But then the right, everybody knew the right time they are going to come in. And everything was sick. In fact, I was clapping. I said, what the fuck? The protocol is going to us and boys. You know, in some places, in Massachusetts now, they have a protocol where they you want to travel, do this point. I said, this is not protocol. Just like Mr. Dato said that immigration is beyond passport. A trained protocol officer, tell me, sir, this is protocol I'm talking about building your team and team spirit. Protocol officer can also be, I said, the government ceremony planner can be a ceremony planner. The bottom line here is that it can help the organization facilitate communication. Cross-cultural and cooperation. Protocols facilitate and enhances PR. Protocol is about goodwill. PR is more of image makers. Organization for Excellence. Dollar targeting. Tactical response. Engagement. Interaction. Which actually we can measure. Now that we call public relations analytics. We can measure them. So, importance of protocol. Embassy public relations. It helps in defend the image of organization protocol now in public relations. It enhances and invents harmony and peace. And that's what we need in this country. Enhance and invent management is still ordinate and etiquette. And it's an event time building world, building pillars. Public diplomacy and public relations. Public diplomacy person don't seem to understand the PR, protocols, public relations, or are so eager not to be tarred with the brush that they are claimed to the conceit of distinction, regardless of facts. What is most important is that we should seek to understand the processes through which an organization or actor in political context of promoting diplomacy seek. This is where the magic is. This is my last goal. I'm almost done. You see, rather than coming with distinction between protocol, if I'm a CEO of a company, believe me, I will establish a protocol office, I will establish a publication office, and I'll make them to work together as a unit. You will see efficiency. The money you spend in hiring those guys, you will see that it's going to reflect on your financial bottom line eventually. Because you see things do seamlessly, and you see your image show up. You see, it's all about, like I say, I'm sorry, it's all about traveling. So this country is not good. I've been to Oregon in the US. I see people sleeping on the streets, University of Oregon, in the streets, sleeping white on the streets. I was in Leeds, see them begging for money. I was in Finland, they were sleeping on the streets. And some people go and take away media and say, this is Lagos. Go to New York. Those are the New York, New York, and New York. And people have come to use that kind of thing and tell me that this country is as if it's the worst country in the world. We truly continue like that. One thing that we are doing things perfectly, yes, we make differences, but at the same time, we cannot accept public opinion set by international press to run the country down. The political officers need to get to their work, and the so-called public officers need to be held to their hands. It's all about perception. The way you see me, the way you talk to me, depends on the kind of person I relate with you. And it's everything in life. It's about image and words and perception. So what is most important, whether you're a political officer or public policy officer, is that let's understand the process. To reach an organization or actor in political context or for political purposes, seek to influence. How do we influence? And to establish, how do we establish ourselves, and to build, how do we build this country, how do we build organizations, and to do what, and maintain beneficial relationships.
Gentlemen, the data is not good, but they are coming to recruit doctors in this country. I mean, the data is not good. I'm going to use myself as an example. The UNESCO, they put me in the UNESCO that I'm not involved.
Nigeria is not good, and I'm a product of this country. And we say, and all we need, I know that we need some differences to make things right. But it's not that bad when people are printing it. I think it should go away the next day. You see, publicly, and that's why we need to maintain that relationship and reputation with its key publics to help support its mission and achieve what is good. Gentlemen, when I travel to any of my courses abroad, I don't wear suits. I don't wear suits. You see me what? In this kind of attire. So when I was in France last time, they were looking the permanent commission in France, the real permanent delegate. They were looking for the situation around. They didn't know you. Somebody told them, hey, what you want? They said, you don't need to look for him. But you see him, you know him. And it's a big conference. You see, when you see him, he's the only person here who dresses in his native country. When you see him, you do what? You know him. I was in Brazil, a professor in Autonomous Basin University of Spain was sitting in my car. He said, look, this car is too fine. And he was wearing it. And you see, that is perception which you create. You dress like them, you eat like them, you speak like them. Then what is your competitive advantage? When is it going to be publication? So publications are not going to see people often producing objectives. You guys, whether publication or what, or public or protocol, it is same objective, the two sides of the coin. To affect public what? Opinion for the benefit of your client or organization. Thank you, ladies and gentlemen.
Thank you very much. Please, a big round of applause for the doctor. You know, when the doctor speaks, there's a difference. Academic docs, I mean. Thank you very much, distinguished ladies and gentlemen. You know, when the doctor was talking about the difference between Canada and Lagos, he said that in Canada, when you arrive, you say, welcome to Canada. But in Nigeria, when you arrive, they tell you this is Lagos.
Dr. Olufemi, the very, very feverishly firebrand doctor, Olumifesi Suraj, put your hands together, please.
He has got a very wonderful.